Every summer, approximately 40 students from around the world come to the Punahou campus to study English as a second language while learning about the Hawaiian culture and environment. The Woe International Center's Pan-Pacific program provides an incredible experience for all who participate in it. The Pan-Pacific program is a four-week program that focuses on intensive English language studies, as well as we integrate Hawaiian culture and science into the curriculum.
This is the third year that I've done it, and this is coincidentally the third year of the Freeman Scholarship Program. And what the Freeman Scholarship allowed the Woe Center to do was open up the Pan-Pacific Program to schools and students from countries other than Japan in particular, or Tahiti, where there aren't as many students with the means to pay for the program. So for the last 3 years, the program has been about half Japanese students and about half students from all around the Pacific Rim.
Because in Tahiti, we have an association that organized trips like this for students. And I went to this association. I already went to Australia. So Annette, who is one of the leaders, told me that I had to go to Hawaii because it was really the best one and I had to try it, so okay, I tried.
Probably the host family experience is the most important component of living abroad because this is your key insight into the local culture and the ways in which the local people think and respond and react to things.
I really enjoy my time when I stay in my parents' family house. I really, because they were so nice, that they were so kind, like I already feel that I be the part of the family, that I was treated like I was also another son for them, like kind of like I really had the time. I enjoyed the time there. They are so like so kind to me, like I really enjoyed it.
For us, we really just really wanted to get Joe out. We found that when we took him out and we talked to him, showed him other experiences, we would in turn hear about his life, which was really what I was interested in hearing about, and I was interested in my family experiencing.
To be honest, that my family, my parents divorced two and a half years ago. So when I stay in this family, my parents, I really feel like I had my whole family again, like, and I had never felt it again for 2.5 years, and this time I can see it again, I can show it again, I can feel it again, that this is a family.
My strength in this is that I work with younger children during the regular year, so I'm really interested in language development. So when I got involved in this, I started seeing if some of the things that I do with younger children who are trying to build their language would work as well with teenagers who are trying to build a language that's their second language.
All participants are supposed to speak English at all times. Okay, they're not supposed to revert back to Japanese or Thai or Malaysian. The actual courses, like in the morning we've got oral for about 50 minutes, which is followed up by reading and writing. Depending on their skill level, we've got them reading different books. One is Makoa, and the other is Blue Skin. So the Blue Skin is the more advanced text, and the Makoa text is for the intermediate and beginning students.
The tie-dye activity actually, it's multi-purpose. First of all, it is one of our Ohana workshop activities in which the kids work as in teams, tie-dyeing their shirts. To help one another.
Yeah, well, the tie-dye thing started off as a functional thing. When we go on excursions, 40 kids, it's hard for us to keep track of them. So we thought 3 years ago, you know what? What if we had something to identify them? How about a really obnoxious tie-dyed shirt? So that's where that came from. We need them to put something on. So turning it into an activity became just sort of a class problem, and again, put them in a situation where they have to deal with instructions outside of their native language, make them work with a buddy, so they have to find ways to communicate in English with their buddy. Also, to have an experience that they haven't had before.
That was the first time for me to do tie-dye. It was really fun, and yeah, I loved it. Because when I started to make my t-shirt, I was afraid because it didn't look really nice, or the colors were melting. But it was really nice. Yeah, I love my t-shirt.
One thing that happens when you get students from different cultures together, there's a fairly intense period of adjustment where they want to stay in their bubble and stay in a zone and do things that they know are accepted and safe. So they're a little reluctant to respond to group activities at first. They're a little reluctant to show their own ability if their culture is one where being too conspicuous is not a good thing. So watching them overcome that is nice. They overcome it first with each other. They understand it's safe to be who you are with someone from a different culture. Then together they sort of realize, in this program in particular, we all have this zone, if you will, where any mistake that we made is going to be forgiven immediately. So cultural faux pas are okay, language faux pas are okay. And they figure that out probably by the fourth or fifth day, the end of the first week. And then things really pick up in terms of them forming strong relationships.
So the Ho'olauleia is really our culmination piece. It's a celebration of student learning. And it's an opportunity for the students to express orally and to present all that they've learned with their host families and friends. So actually, there are three pieces to the Ho'olauleia. First of all, there are the learning presentations. And the learning presentations come in a variety of forms. Throughout the 3 weeks, the students are keeping daily journals. They are writing compositions. They're doing hands-on activities. They're going on excursions. And so there's always some kind of reflective piece that follows. The second component is culture sharing. And this is the part that is just so much fun for them, because all of the students play the roles of both teacher and learners. And when the students are selected, they are asked to bring with them either a song or a dance or a little mini play or a skit or a poem, something that they could teach to their peers in the Pan Pacific program. And they, in turn, would be able to learn something from one of their peers from another country. And the kids have, during the 3 weeks, really practiced very hard teaching and learning. And it's just a nice way, really, to wrap up. It really allows the kids to collectively reflect upon their learning for the last 3 weeks and to share. And then the third component is actually the awarding of diplomas, where the kids will receive official diplomas for their participation in the Pan Pacific program. And then it's followed by a potluck dinner with our host families. So again, it's another opportunity to bring in the host families and to show our appreciation to them.
The friends in Pan Pacific program from all countries, Panese, Chinese, and so many, I really enjoyed the time with them, because they're not like, you're from another country, so I don't want to talk to you. We just have our time together too. You're from another country, so let's together and play. We have our own time, and all of the experience from our excursions, the field trip, it will be a memorable thing for me.
I think the most important component that the kids take back with them is the human relationships that they have formed with students throughout the Asia Pacific region, as well as their host families. So much of what we do in education that involves international programs is that we want students to really be able to see through the eyes, hearts, and minds of others. And the way they do this best is having firsthand cross-cultural experiences. So by actually being able to live in Hawaii, even for a short period of time, being part of the United States, being part of six other cultures other than their own, it makes a tremendous difference. And I think it really is a transformative experience for these kids.